So definitely the end of slavery and dead products is coming in a big way to planet Earth. Just dumb dead products. Just stupid stuff. I strongly believe, and I'm going to preach on this, I had a word from the Lord yesterday morning, March 15th, which is a huge joy day, and it was back to Eden. Okay. Back to Eden is a beautiful five fest. It's 35 in the center and 35 at the bookends. Just like the word stop, the famous stop sign, it's identical. Back to Eden. Okay. That was a word I felt I had from the Lord. And I literally spent the entire day yesterday, almost Eden-esque, you know, just taking care of the body, the Lord's house. But back to Eden, it's almost identical to the letter stop. I mean, the back is S minus 2, T, O is in order in the middle, and then P is 2 points off from Eden, less. Okay, back to Eden. But the joy of doing that, okay? The fives. No one cares about your dead products, man. Like, most of them. I'm like, yeah, we know. God has ordained video. Of course. He's ordained the internet. Of course. He's ordained computers. Of course, of course, of course. But there are 99.9% of so-called of products in this world that no one cares about. Folks, like, there comes a point when you're just like, okay, God is the infinite one. It's like all the children down here, they're all doing little, like, pictures with their crayons, like, creating all these things with their little crayons and, like, posting it on the walls and, like, screaming at each other and say, hey, buy my picture, buy my picture. My creation is so cool. And God's like, this is so stupid. Like, when you kids gonna grow up, focus on taking care of, like, living things and... It's like, I. Just dead product after dead product. Okay. Doesn't make any sense, and it just makes slavery out of tons of people. It really is demonic, and it's all spiritual deadness. One thing that I've noticed about non-Christianity, the number one thing you see with someone who's not a Christian, is low self-esteem. Period. It is. Okay? The spirit is dead without Jesus Christ. That's exactly the truth. That's what the Bible says. Okay? And, that's why. That is the official reason. Guys, the official reason why there is slavery on planet Earth, and people who are slave to dumb addictions and dumb jobs is because of non-Christianity. It's because they have not received Jesus on the inside of them. It's that simple. They are still slaves of the devil. Okay? It's just... It's gross. I'm like, if Christ filled every single human on planet Earth, you would see so much freedom, you would see so much liberality, and above all, unholy addictions die. Just people choosing dumb things, and people buying dumb things, and people spending their life around dumb things, and people watching dumb things, and people just... working in dumb environments and just dumb clutter everywhere that no one cares about. I mean, at the end of the day, we are going to heaven, okay? Or if you're not a Christian, you're going to hell, okay? Everyone is responsible for their own decision, though. Everyone is responsible for finding and choosing God. This is just a revelation. It doesn't matter if you were born in a non-Christian country or if you're 1,000 miles from the nearest Bible for your whole life. The Bible says, and there's stories, people getting visions from Jesus in the night, and they get saved. And he starts talking to them. And they have a personal relationship with him living in the jungle. They do. Speaking a language that no one else knows. I'm not even joking. It's all real. And it doesn't matter if you grew up without a Bible. It doesn't matter if you don't have a Bible. 1,000 miles into the jungle, if that's where you grew up. And it's like, if you cry out to the Maker, as he promised, if you just look around at all the created works of the Maker, and you cry out and say, God, can you please show me yourself, tell me about yourself, and tell me what you want me to do to please you. The first thing he'll do is reveal his triune nature to you. The first thing he'll do is reveal to you Jesus Christ. Jesus might even show up in person in front of you and say, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And just start telling you about himself. Okay? And yeah, that person gets saved just as easily as the person over in the West. Like it's like everyone is responsible for their own salvation. In the sense that they have to cry out to God and ask for enlightenment. And just rampant dead products everywhere, though. Man. I have a strong feeling, though, that there is a spiritual conviction that is coming, and it's already here, to North America. Okay. And I tell you, I just, man, the whole food thing. Like, can everyone please cry out to God, like, in private, for deliverance from unholy consumption patterns? Like, if you want your life to be gorgeous, if you want your life to be close to God and his likeness, and you want your life to actually be honorable, you know, and bear fruit in God's kingdom and be glorious and all the rest of it, you've got to draw near to God. Like, I do not know what's wrong with this country. I mean, I do know what's wrong with this country. Spiritually, people are far from God. They just don't know him, and they don't spend enough time in prayer listening for him and seeking, you know, the truth and the word. It's literally the sickest North America you could probably ask for right now. In terms of leadership, in terms of elders, I'm like, let's not kid ourselves, folks. The current adult, is saying so little about God, it is disgusting. I'm like, when you become of age, when you are an adult, you are supposed to have much to say about the true God. Because if you don't, who is going to talk to us about the true God if adults and people of age do not? You think young people are supposed to do that? Well, God will raise up anyone. But it's just a point of absolute stupidity. And I am calling Christian people, men in particular, to open your mouth like never before about why you are here. Like, get to know God, okay? And God has ordained us to have the internet, and he's ordained us to have YouTube, and he's ordained us to have video cameras and all these wonderful channels that people can share like crazy. And video is awesome. I love video, and it lasts forever, you know, God willing, until Jesus comes back, and it can bless people worldwide. God ordained it, you know? But it's just... The other thing you'll discover as you start expressing yourself spiritually and talking about God is that it grows you. It actually grows you. And it sets you free from, you know, you can tell it's a nourishment, as the Bible says. Okay. It's early in the morning here. And I just gotta respect everyone in this house, but it just, my goodness. You can just tell, it's not hard, folks. I'm like, it's not hard to see how far most people are from God. I'm like, you see it everywhere. Pray for a revolution. Be the revolution. Make sure that you yourself are clinging as close to God as possible. I mean, honestly, folks, I believe that one thing, the Bible says the wages of sin is death. And one thing, like, if nothing changes, you know, the wicked perish. They simply die young if they don't repent. And when I say young, I mean, like, God's standards of young versus old are very different from the modern human. People think, oh yeah, no, he lived a good full life of 70, you know, 80 years. I'm like, not compared to what God thinks is life. Like, back in Eden, they lived over 900 years. And God was like, yeah, no, this is just right. Like, the wages of sin actually is physical death and ultimately eternal death and, like, separation from God, which is pure torment. And so you're just like, Satan has not changed, really, in the past 6,000 years. Just because technology is different today doesn't mean that people's battle, okay, for physical health and true human behavior is any different than it was 5,000 years ago. Okay? I'm like, Satan knows that you're an eternal soul. He knows that people are eternal souls. He hates people. And, okay, yada, 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 he wants to destroy people. I'm like, God wants you alive and happy and healthy and all the rest of it. All right. Well, the Christian is commanded to rejoice. Remember, it's like, you are in charge of yourself. It's your own dance with God. Though the whole world, you know, it's just, God is sovereign, so. Okay. He'll be in charge of everyone. Just be yourself today. That's pretty much it.